National Days, that territory was given to me. And I have done it. Whatever work was given, I always did it. Today, as I stand here before you, there are mixed feelings. And as you all know me, I don't like to say bye. It's always see you. In Marathi, we say, me zaate, we never say me zaate. We always say me gente. And I will always be a phone call away. I cannot imagine myself minus ADHS. And when I joined the school in 1986, I was young with hardly any experience. Today, whatever I'm leaving with bag full of good experiences, maturity, and all this I have got from various experiences our boys have given me. Whether it was maramari or running away from the school or hitting each other, carrying weapons to like small chakus and all, then popping cases during the exams, and the list is endless as all of us know. For bringing fake parents also to that extent. That is, the person is not a parent but a vendor from the footpath. Even to that extent, I had experienced it. Till then, I didn't know that we could catch somebody and bring to the teacher as mother or father or even uncle for that matter. But these various experiences, what we get from our students, I think enriches us. It helps us to take decisions. It helps us to, because every time I said, yeah, last time this happened, I must deal with the problem in this manner. But every time the problem was different and every time the solution was also different. Anyway, today I am going from the services, retiring from the services, active services as a teacher from ADHS. Now onwards, I will be known as ex-ADHS teacher, and that ADHS will never go away from me. Like how we are attached to our mother with an umbilical cord. In the same manner, I am always attached to ADHS, irrespective whether I am doing work for any other sector also. Because I will be now onwards actively involved with a lot of projects related to the rural area, whether it is RMC, but Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan and other government projects which are mainly dealt with the rural area. I will be associated with that. At the same time, I will definitely be here, and I will remember I am always just a phone call away. In the past, whether I was a teacher, whether I was a supervisor or a vice principal, I have always said I am a teacher. I have never bothered about what posts were attached to me. And in case, if I had pulled up teachers, for some reason or the other, it was always for the betterment of the teacher herself and at the same time for the students and the institute. I never had or have right now also never had also any personal grudges against anyone. And I always believe you give good, you get good back. And whatever awards I got, I always believe that were the gifts given to me by God. God has sent us, for every person is sent down for some purpose. If we do our work sincerely, loyally, I think everybody gets into it. And then we don't need to go to temples or churches or mosques or pray. Sit with prayer book and pray. If we do our work sincerely, honestly, dedicatedly, I think every prayer of yours is answered. You don't have to go to God and say, give me this. God will automatically give you a prayer. Just a passing farewell thanks speech. I know this is very philosophical, but I said sometimes I need to be. Not second innings has to start, so I need to be, I think, calm down now. And very little philosophical, and now like what we can say, that tapo nahi girna kam karna chahiye na. Like I'm known in my group as more tapori and more fighter. And my husband is here. Both of us are like North Pole, South Pole. He is a person who has always kept a ice slab on his head. I am exactly the opposite and always a volcano. And even if I do say something, I always be telling why to keep things in heart. Bring it, let it come out. And my habit is that it has to come out of my system. Whether it is good or bad. It is out of my system means I am at peace. How the person opposite takes it, it is his or her problem. And he is always been a very, very non-controversial person, whether it is in our society or whether it is at his job. Because when I attended his farewell, coincidentally both of us retired on the same day, 31st March, lawfully 31st March. And when I attended his farewell, everybody kept on saying he is a very non-controversial person. And I think there also we are opposite, and I am a very controversial person. Whether it is from the gate to the management, in every controversy, Reena Kulkarni has to be. Whatever it is, without the Reena Kulkarni, the controversy doesn't get over. So both of us have always been poles apart. Still, we are together. I think God only makes pairs like this. So that tolerance is, and there is a balance. And we are blessed with two beautiful children and a beautiful daughter-in-law. And in spite of all the though family is complete, I still feel I can't sit at home. There are a lot of things to be done and a lot of hobbies to be pursued. So I am busy with all that. Just a small message to all of you. Do not stand for long at any door till you are pushed out. Do not hesitate, do not turn back. Move ahead with conviction. Look forward, work hard as you move ahead with complete dedication and loyalty. With good self-motivation and confidence, you can achieve everything. Do not get depressed with failures. Get up with more confidence and conviction for the next race. One gets good things when you wait, when one gets better things when you try, and one gets best things when you trust your hard work, loyalty and dedication. Life is tough but not impossible. Thank you very much all of you for a lovely, what I can say, I will not say farewell. Just a parting messages and parting togetherness till we meet, and I will keep coming. I am going to attend all functions, don't worry. I will not, unless I am out of station, but I will be there, and for anything, we are there on the WhatsApp group also, and for any problem of any kind, I am just a phone call. Thank you very much, all of you, once again.